Eberhard Voit. I'm a professor of biomedical engineering at Georgia Tech. My role in MAPIC is systems biology. My lab does computational modeling, and we try to take the data that will be developed and generated by other groups and put them into a functional context. Well, the first role of computer models is the bookkeeping. There are so many data and there's so much information that it's just too much for a human brain to capture and consolidate and organize it. So computer models are very helpful in that respect because we can store a lot and we can relate it to each other. Ultimately, we hope to understand the processes that are involved in malaria in a mechanistic way where we can manipulate processes, optimize processes toward treatment. When we can translate a biological phenomenon into such a model, we can analyze that model much more efficiently than we can analyze the biological system. So we can do millions of experiments that would be impossible to do in reality. Biologists in the past have been trained to study phenomena in detail, going from the function of an organ to the function of a tissue to the function of a cell, down to molecules, genes, metabolites. What systems biology tries to do is putting the pieces back together into a functional context so that we can analyze what exactly the role of a particular part is in a bigger system or bigger phenomenon. Well, MAPIC has a unique opportunity to merge data from different levels of biological organization. So we will have data on gene expression, metabolite levels, protein prevalences, all the way up to human disease of markers and disease processes. And by combining all these, we hope to get a deeper understanding and deeper insights into the processes that control this disease.